Hi guys, it's Mike here, one go short play. As you know, I make games art and games music, but I also work at a school. And part of my job there is setting up a games arcade at the school, which I did last year with much success. And this year, through a series of complications, I've had to move the games arcade, but I'm also looking at upgrading it and making a few changes to it now. I was going to do a video about my channel and the histories, the whys and wherefores of it, but something arrived last week which got me proper excited, and I thought instead I would share this something with you. So, over to me in the middle of last week when my parcel arrived. Enjoy. Hey fellow retroheads, I'm at work. It's a late Monday afternoon. All the kids had gone home and I had totally forgotten that I had ordered a parcel. I've never done like an unboxing before, but I'm really excited about this. All right, start at the beginning. Basically, in this school, I am building a retro gaming arcade. I'm just going to give you a little look at it because it's early days. Well, this is the redraft of it. I'm having to rebuild it in a different part of the building, but I think this suits it much better. You ready? There we go. And as you can see, a few of the consoles are just starting to happen. I'll go backwards in time, eh? So we're starting with a Wii, basically, there. And you can see there's a few gaps where things are going to go. Well, basically, down to the N64. There's going to be another couple of tables here, which I'm currently putting in. And then we've got that kind of, you can see I've got a gap here. But that's stuff like the 3DO and the Jaguar and the Amiga 32. Even the, what's it called, the Mega CD. I haven't got one of them yet. The SNES going there. The Mega Drive going here. But this is the PS de resistance. There's loads more over there, Atari 2600, Spectrum, Commodore 64, Amstrad, all that sort of thing, Master System, NES, and Atari ST. But this is my own Amiga from back in the day. Yes, it's very yellow. Thing is, I want to take it home and all my discs. So I ordered this in from the school. You can kind of tell what it is, can't you? Okay, what? Alright, I guess that's some sort of packaging. And lots and lots. Right, this is what we bought. An Amiga. Yes, we've got a Mega Drive pad hooked up to it. Yes, I've heard about the dangers of having 2 and 3 button pads on the Amiga. And no, I've never seen anything bad happen as a result of it. Having owned an Amiga for, well, since 92. Here is the Gotek drive. Now, there were a few things I was a little concerned about when I bought the Amiga. One, it didn't come with any of this stuff. The modulator or the any of the leads, in fact. It came with the power pack, but of course that power pack was German, because I bought it in Germany. Doesn't matter, I'm currently using my own power pack from my own Amiga and all my own bits from my own Amiga. I might have to buy the rest of it separately for school, and then I'll be able to take my Amiga home. But this was the thing. I was a little concerned with how flimsy that, you can't really tell, it seems alright now, but how flimsy that, you know, the casing is on the Amiga. This one's not as well cased as mine. Now it could just be that less screws have gone into it, and that's fine. I can always add more screws to it. But the thing that bothered me the most was this. Look at that. I better not do that while it's on, actually. But let me just turn that off, okay. So there's the Gotek. When I try and put my USB in, I mean, it goes right in. I'm not happy about that. I was hoping it would be kind of sturdy. It probably means I'll have to go in there and, you know, sort it out. The bottom line, though, is if this all works, I don't mind. And, well, there it is. I've just hooked it up to the Wii telly at the minute. So it's on the wrong bit of the room. It should be over there, where my old Amiga is. I've got loads to set up. Here it is. Let's just reset it and run through what it does. Okay, so what it does, apparently, is DOS, cool. Then, initiation in progress, and then it goes to that and does that. Now, it looks like that's deliberate, but I'm not sure it is. So I'm going to find out what's going on there and get back to you. It was something really stupid. In my excitement to get the Amiga set up, I had the mouse plugged into the joystick port and vice versa. In my defense, I was yet to use the Gotek at all. And let's face it, I'm like a kid at Christmas. Let's flip the camera and have a look. And there it is. So the bottom line is, it works. It all works. There we are on the screen. I'm basically using the joystick or pad in this case. This is basically how it works. It's picking up everything that I put on my little fob there. I put an emulator on there, which came with it on a little CD, and a few games. So if I go to ADF and press the button, there we go. Okay, Mega Drive pad. So these are the games that came with it. Now, the way I want to set this up, most of these are two disc games, and I'm looking for one disc games because what I don't want the kids to have to do, bear in mind, these are what? 16 to 15, 14 even, to 18 year olds. They know nothing about the Amiga, they know nothing about the Gotek. They don't know that to swap a disc on that Gotek in there, you have to press a button up and down. And I don't want them to mess with it if possible. I'm probably going to get a smaller, you know, USB stick as well. That's my own one from home. So what we want to do is make all the games very accessible to them from the word go. Bearing in mind this room is going to be full of games consoles. I need about an hour or so, maybe an hour and a half, to set them all up. And that's, you know, every time I open it. So I've selected a bunch of games that are one disc. I'm working my way through attaching them to the numbers on there. And as I say, I've selected one disc games. Now, bearing in mind we've got 30 odd weeks in our academic year, I need to have about 30 odd games ready, because I'm going to cycle them on a weekly basis. Now, I've just hit the reset button. You'll see it's loading up a demo scene intro for the Addams Family. The reason for that is because the Gotek is set to 001. Now, the disk drive's not doing anything, so I'm considering it safe to press the buttons. Of course, it changes the disk. The issue is, if I press those buttons now, I can't really do that, so I've got to hold it by the USB, which is not ideal. Something I'm going to have to fix at some point very soon. But for now, I'm going to hold it by the USB and press through the numbers until I get to, what was that, 14? In fact, I can just go backwards. In fact, let's see if I can do it with one hand. Just go backwards and, no, I've pulled out the USB. See, not ideal. Give us a sec. There. Now, I had to push the USB back in by pushing that right into the Amiga. It went, like, right in there. It was really not great. Okay, so what I want is the game ready to play when the kids come down here. So I want to get past all the Fairlight intro, get past all the trainers. I don't want the trainers on, because I want the students to kind of see how difficult the games were. So let's just skip all this. So here we go. Okay, so Hunter's not ideal. Hunter probably needs 1 megabyte of RAM, or a 500 plus. No, it'll be 1 megabyte of RAM, won't it? This is an original 500 with no extra memory in. Old chestnut. What I'm going to do then is, now I'm going to replace Hunter, damn shame, with something that I know works, using exactly the same process, just going through that list of games. And finally, there it is working. You can probably guess from the sounds what I'm playing. Well, running. Yeah, bit of IK Plus. Works a treat. I think you'll enjoy that. Okay, that's pretty much me going from completely having no idea how to use that Gotek to using the Gotek. There it is, working. If I can do it, anyone can. So yeah, that's that. I might even do a couple of videos of this as it gets set up. Let me know if you'd like to see that, and it's exactly what I'll do. All right, thanks for watching, guys. See you later.